Investing can be so confusing. Where do you start? What are the best accounts? And are there certain accounts that are better to start with? Today, we are breaking down our own order of investing so that you can develop a smoking hot fire plan for yourself. So let's get started.
Hey guys, I'm Ryan.
And I'm Kayla.
And we are vloggers at familyandfi.com, where we talk about everything from saving, earning, and investing money to reach financial independence and retiring early. Hit that subscribe button if you are getting in on this movement.
Today we are sharing our order of investing to reach FIRE, which stands for financial independence and retiring early. Now, everyone's fire plan is going to be different, but we hope that by explaining our own fire plan, we can help you better understand investing and help you create a fire plan for yourself. If you would like to download our free Order of Investing for FIRE workbook, where we go into the details about investing and give you a fire plan guide, visit familyandfi.com/investingforfire or click the link in the description.
Yeah, that packet is gold if you're new to investing. And always do your own research before making any kind of financial decisions. Now that that disclaimer is out there, we'll move on. If you watch our recent net worth reveal video, you know that we doubled our net worth within the last year, and that was mostly due to investing.
Investing is so important for your future if you ever wish to retire someday. When you invest for your future, the goal is to have your money make money and use the power of compound interest. Unfortunately, investing isn't usually free though. You'll likely have to pay taxes and fees. The goal of any investor is to reduce these fees as much as possible and keep as much money as possible.
That's why the order in which you invest is so important. Not all investment accounts are created equal, and you want to take advantage of the ones that offer benefits before investing in the ones that do not.
Exactly. We take advantage of tax advantage accounts first because they will grow at a much higher rate than non-tax advantage accounts because of compound interest, matches, and tax benefits. I also want to note really quick that before we started investing, we had an emergency fund. You don't want to have to pull out of your retirement accounts to cover your emergencies, so have that first.
Yeah, that would be good to have first. So the first account that we chose to invest in was my 401k, which is also referred to as a thrift savings plan for federal employees. We invested in my 401k first because my employer currently gives a 3% match up to 6%. So what does that mean? That means that we can move 6% of our annual salary into my 401k, and they will contribute half of that back for us. For example, let's say I make $50,000 a year. I can put $3,000 of tax deferred money into my 401k, and my employer will put in $1,500 into that account. Investing in our 401k gives us three advantages. First, the employer match is free money that we did not want to miss out on. Second, the money we contributed is tax deferred, meaning that we haven't paid taxes on it yet, and therefore we get to gain earnings from good old Uncle Sam's money. Third, when you contribute to a 401k, your contributions lower your overall taxable income. If you need help setting up this through your employer, talk to your HR department.
The second account we invest in is my personal favorite, the Roth IRA. A Roth IRA is another tax advantage account. However, this one is a little different. Money that you put into a Roth IRA is post-tax money, meaning money that you've already paid taxes on. This money grows completely tax-free and can be withdrawn completely tax-free for any reason after the age 59 and a half. However, what makes this account really great is that you can withdraw any money you contributed at any time without penalty. So for example, if you put $50,000 over the years into your Roth IRA and it grew to be $70,000, you could withdraw up to $50,000 without penalty. So in a way, the Roth IRA works as an emergency fund and a retirement account. Another thing I want to mention is that stay-at-home parents can qualify for an IRA if their married spouse meets the requirements. As a stay-at-home parent myself, this is something no one ever told me about. But I'm telling you right now that as long as you meet the requirements for eligibility, stay-at-home parents can have an IRA.
As long as one of the spouses has taxable earned income, which can be wages, tips, self-employment income, commissions, taxable alimony, and even non-taxable combat pay, the other spouse can open a Roth IRA.
You can contribute up to the maximum for both accounts, which as of right now is $6,000 for people under the age of 50 and $7,000 for people 50 and older. It is our goal to max out both Ryan's IRA and mine every year. Let me know in the comments if you knew that non-wage earning spouses could have an IRA, because I want to know if this information is top secret as I am thinking it is, because no one I talk to knows about this.
Number three in our order of investing is the health savings account, otherwise known as an HSA. We put this as our number three because it's lower priority than our Roth IRA. However, we do invest some money into our HSA all year long, even if we haven't maxed out our IRAs yet.
We love the HSA because it is the only account that at least we know of that has triple tax advantages. First, your contributions are tax deductible. Second, your money will grow tax-free. And third, you don't have to pay tax on the withdrawals if you withdraw the money for qualified medical expenses.
Now, in order to get tax-free growth, you actually have to invest the money you put into it. Many people don't even know that you can invest money in your HSA. So if that's you, now you know. Most people just put money into their HSA and let it sit there. If you do that, you are actually losing money due to inflation. We'll do a video going into more HSA details in the future because there are a ton of benefits of having one. If you can't wait until then, we'll link an article explaining the HSAs in the description below.
Now the 401k, Roth IRA, and HSA are our three main stock market investments. We believe these should be the accounts that most people invest in first. And for most people, maxing out these accounts is a hefty goal. So don't be discouraged if you don't have all these accounts yet. As you grow your financial literacy and start to make financial strides, investing will become so natural.
The fourth step in our investing order right now is actually building up an account for non-liquid assets, which for us is our rental property fund. You may not be interested in including an investment like this in your FIRE plan, and that's okay.
Yeah, like we said, everyone's goals are different. For this account, we opened a high interest savings account that we are building up until we have a good chunk of money to put into buying our first rental property. Now, if we didn't want to buy rental property, we would go back to the 401k and work on contributing the max amount allowed, which is currently $19,500 a year. We would, of course, take advantage of this because of the tax benefits that we mentioned earlier.
The last investment account we have built into our plan is one that we haven't actually built yet, but it's included when we decide to incorporate it.
Yes, that account happens to be a normal, non-tax advantage brokerage account. We haven't done much investing in these accounts because we are still working on our goals with the other accounts.
Remember, when you develop your long-term goals and plans, you don't want to just think about what you can do right now. Including action steps for when you acquire more wealth only motivates you to contribute to grow.
Now, we have some normal brokerage accounts that we invest in right now, but it's only to take advantage of stocks we want to buy quickly and to get free stocks. For example, we both have an M1 Finance, Robinhood, and Webull account because they give you at least one free stock just for opening an account.
Sometimes up to six free stocks. Good ones, too.
And they give you free stocks for referring other people too. So we always refer each other when we sign up for these accounts.
We downloaded these apps when we first started investing so we could watch and learn about the stock market without using our own money.
If you don't have an account with these brokerage companies, you should download the apps and get your free stocks because it's an awesome benefit that might not last forever. And of course, we love for you to use our referral links in the description, but even if you don't, it's still free money that you should be jumping on. So check them out.
Now, if you follow us, you know that we have children and you may be wondering, well, why aren't you contributing to a 529 plan or other investment options for your kids? Well, we haven't forgotten about them and we actually have a pretty unique system in place for their future. We want to do an entire video on this, so be sure to subscribe and click that notification bell to get more future videos.
Now that you've seen our order of investing for FIRE, we hope you can better understand why order with retirement accounts matters. Don't forget that you can download the free workbook we made to help you develop your own plan. If you already have a FIRE plan, let us know what you do differently in the comments.
And we'll see you on the next video.